another amazing newsweek. One cannot but imagine we are watching a soap opera. Indeed, today's gospel reading makes it even more, much clearer. It is a soap opera. As we hear in the gospel reading, the second reading for today, Nathaniel asking a very serious question. Can anything good come out of Nazareth? One can give one's answer, but I'm not going to go there this morning. We continue to pray for this world, faced with so many challenges, so many questions, so many fears. That's why I have chosen to talk with us. I think it is important for us to talk about us, people, and where we are called to be in this world. For therein is our hope. One of the Psalms begins this way: O God, you are my God. Eagerly I seek you. That is but one example of a testimony of humanity's desire to seek something that's meaningful. For the psalmist, it was God. We are all caught up in a search for meaning in life, for a sense of purpose. What is my life meant to be about? What am I called to do and to be? For us Christians and for those in the Christian tradition, we have a story of one whom we do seek, or who offers for us rather a purpose and meaning. Indeed, he said, our Lord said, I am the way and the truth and the life. He also said, I came that they may have life and have it abundantly. So we have some possibilities in our search of finding something in Jesus. But how do we come to experience that fullness of life? I suggest to us that there are about three ways that we come to experience that fullness of life that's found in Jesus. Some, like John and Andrew, find him because they look for him. They heard John the Baptist preaching about the Lamb of God who was coming, this one whose shoes he could not untie. And what they heard of him was such that they felt, let's go and find this Jesus. Perhaps there's something there. So they, on their own volition, went to find Jesus. And as we continue this season of Epiphany, we have stories of persons who deliberately set out to find Jesus. The story of the Magi, who themselves set out. The story says they saw a star heart and they determine, we want to find this Jesus. So they, on their own, set out. The shepherds heard the angel's story and testimony, and they said, we're going to go and find this Jesus. Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place. We have observed the star in the east, the wise men said, the Magi said, and have come to pay him homage. So they, examples of persons whose desire and intention was to find Jesus. But there are many who do not feel that as their vocation, or they have other things on their mind and their heart that they want to address first, and so they're not inclined to go to find Jesus. However, in their lives, God has placed persons who can help them discover this Jesus and lead them to Jesus. In John's Gospel, we hear of Andrew bringing Peter to Jesus. Nathanael was brought by Philip to Jesus. For they had in some way experienced who he was and felt it important that others ought to have a feel for this Jesus. And so they invited them, come and meet Jesus. He's worth meeting. There's something here that we may all benefit from. So they invited others. Not only did they invite someone else, we read in the book of the Acts of the Apostles another similar invitation. The man who sat at the gate called Beautiful, crippled from birth, and whose only purpose in life was to sit and await a handout, that he too may get his daily bread. And on that day in question, as Peter and John were going to the temple to pray, as was their custom, he sat at the temple gate, and as custom, he waited to receive his handout. But Peter said to him, silver and gold have I none, but what I have, I give to you. In the name of Jesus, rise up and walk. Peter did not give him a handout for his daily bread, but Peter provided for him the opportunity to meet Jesus, whose prayer said, give us this day our daily bread. And so he was able to rise up, to jump up off on his feet and go and praise God in the temple. And he must have, as they would gather them in their homes during the week, found time to come closer to experience who Jesus was. But he was able to meet Christ through the efforts of other persons. But not all of us seek Jesus, seek out God on our own. Not all of us have been privileged to be brought to Jesus by some other person. So often, many of us have been found by Christ himself. There's no third party involved as such. Many of us have been found by the one who knows us. The psalmist said this morning as we heard the psalm chanted, you have searched me out and known me. And so in the gospel, we find Christ himself searching out Philip. We're told the next day Jesus decided to go to Galilee. He found Philip and said to him, "Follow me." Philip probably had no plans to go anywhere that day, but Jesus saw him and said to him, "Come, follow me." We read many stories in the gospel of that very nature. Matthew, at his workstation, a publican, tax collector, one thought to have been sold out to the Romans, one hated by his own people, one you would not expect to be in a Lord's company, Jesus sought him out. "Follow me." And Matthew became one of his disciples. Remember Saul? Saul had no plans to follow Jesus. Saul had other plans to destroy the church that proclaimed Jesus as Lord. But the story says to us, on that Damascus road, it was Jesus who found Paul, found Saul. And Saul protested, "Why do you persecute me? Who are you, Lord?" He said, "I'm Jesus." You go to the street called Straight, and there you will hear what you've got to do. He found Saul. We heard little Samuel, even little Samuel, poor guy, in the story, trying to get some sleep at night, his voice in his ear, "Samuel, Samuel." He didn't know it was God calling him. God found Samuel and called him into service. Abraham, in his land, the Ur of the Chaldees, had no thought about Yahweh, the living God. He followed other gods, as did his forefathers before him. But God called Abraham to leave his home and go to a land that I will give you, and you will be the father of many nations. God finds you when you least expect it. And sometimes we go screaming and struggling, "Not me, Lord, I don't want this." But God finds us. The point, my friends, is this, that we come to God in so many ways. Out of our own desire, discover something through the examples and the call of others, or the direct way, where God says, "I want you for ministry." Maybe for some of us, we have had all three experiences at some point along the way. Yes, we have set out to find God in our own personal journeys. And while on the way, we meet others who encourage us to continue with that, because they themselves have been involved. They are also involved, and they are encouraging us to keep on keeping on. Or we discover one day, God wants me. Whatever the case, the result is the same. There is joy. The Magi and the shepherds went to find Jesus, and when they left, they went back rejoicing. We told the shepherds return to their homes, giving glory and praise to God joyfully. The Magi went on another way, no doubt pleased that they did in fact discover Jesus. But there was joy. The man at the gate, beautiful, also found joy. He leapt with praises, glorifying God. Zacchaeus, he was, we're told, sitting in the tree, looking to see what's going on, and Jesus found him. And he too went home, because Jesus said, I'm going to your house. I'm not only going to call you, I'm going to eat with you today, Jack Zacchaeus. You know the Sunday school hymn? I'm sure John knows that hymn. You know, I'm going to your house for tea. He had joy in being in Christ's presence. One who was like Matthew despised as a publican. He was glad that Jesus could find him and go into his house. There's joy in that. Where do we hear God calling us? How do we hear God calling us? How do we discover who God is? Is it in our daily journeys, as we read us for ourselves, just are open to discovering, searching, or is there someone in our lives that encourager, that assures, supports, and shows us the good thing it is to be in the house of the Lord, in God's service? Or is it that God has marked us and calls us himself? Like Isaiah, in the temple, engage in worship, but he heard a voice in that amazing kadosh glory of God. Who shall I send? Who will go for me? And he said, here am I, send me. God calls, my friends. It's easy, just follow. And we will discover, my friends, the joy that there is in being in God's presence. God bless us and keep us in our walk with God.